But what's more interesting is something else they tell us. Apparently, I didn't know this, if our geneticists are right, 175,000 years ago in the Rift Valley of Africa, there were 10,000 anatomically modern humans walking the savannas, our ancestors. They located one woman. They called her the mitochondrial DNA Eve. Apparently, her genes passed through, the other ladies did not. The Bible got this one right, Adam and Eve. 70,000 years ago, they located one man in the Rift Valley, Africa. They call him the Y chromosome Adam. His genes passed through. So everyone in this room, here we are. All 6 billion people on the earth, here we are. We all came from two people. We're family. We're family. So if I show up at your house, you have to provide. We're family. Isn't this strange? It could have been hundreds, but it turns out it wasn't. We have to begin thinking as Homo sapiens. We have to create global consciousness. We have to see ourselves as a species, not just a human race. Last one. You know, since World War II, we have talked about all sorts of human rights, and we've encoded all sorts of rights. But there is one supreme right and responsibility that we've yet to encode in our declarations. It's the ultimate right and responsibility. And that is every human being, every species, every animal, every organism on this planet, has the right of their fair share of the energy that bathes the earth. That's how we survive and flourish. We have been sending out television and radio shows to the universe for years trying to communicate. Nobody's calling us back. Maybe they're smarter than I think. They don't want to call us back until we get it together. We don't see life anywhere in the earth, in the universe. So every human, every species, every organism on this little planet, this experiment called life, has the right to their fair share of the energy that bathes this planet. Today, we human beings are 0.5% of the entire animal biomass. We're only 0.5%. We're using 40% of the photosynthesis. That's not sustainable. So we need to do this. Understand that we each have a right to our fair share of the energy that bathes this planet so we can flourish and continue this mystery called life, which is so important to us. Each morning we get up and say, I'm alive. I'm not sure why, but I like this. This is the legacy we need to carry on to future generations. So here's what we do in Sicily. With President Lombardo's help, with the business community, with the civil society, with the academic community, all three pillars, government, civil society, the business community, come together. You usher in a third industrial revolution here in Sicily. You create power to the people and distributed capitalism here in Sicily. You become a flagship for Italy and the European Union here in Sicily. You become a lighthouse to the Mediterranean, North Africa, and the rest of the world here in Sicily. You can do this. And you can do this in the next 10, 15, 20 years. And if you set this flagship up here with the 5 million people on this little island, Sicily, the legacy you leave will live on for generations to come. Maybe we have a chance to reduce the temperature change on this planet. Maybe we have a chance to save our species. Maybe we have a chance to steward our fellow creatures who have a right to be here with us or without us. And if you can create a sustainable Sicily, we can create a sustainable world. And if we can create a sustainable world, we can continue with this great experiment called life on this little planet. I look forward to working with you. Good morning.